Why use external tools to swap a face when you already have the solution at hand? And the solution does not involve installing proprietary development environments. Automatic 11.11 Web UI, including ControlNet with the plus face IP adapter, is a simple and flexible solution for swapping a face. In this video, you will learn in detail how to install the additional ControlNet checkpoints and perform the face swap using various examples. Let's start. We use Stable Diffusion with Automatic 11.11 Web UI and need ControlNet for the face swap. If you haven't installed it yet, you can find the necessary instructions in my video above about upscaling. Two additional models are required for the face swap. The first one is an IP adapter from H94 on Hugging Face. You find all links in the description below. Download the IP adapter plus face SD15 safe tensors. The second one is from Ilias Wiel, I hope that's the correct pronunciation. Download the file SD15 openpose pth. We put the IP adapter plus face into the Stable Diffusion Web UI directory in models controlnet. OpenPose goes into Stable Diffusion Web UI, extensions, SD Web UI ControlNet, models. In the extensions tab of your Web UI, you can check for updates, especially of ControlNet, and apply and quit. You might have to restart your backend. In order to prepare some pictures for the face swap, I have used the Epic Realism model. You can find how to install it in my upscale video too. In the image to image tab, I'll put the target image, so where we will swap the face to. Seeing this man from the side and the sunlight are a bit challenging, but it will work. We enable ControlNet Unit O and put the image with the source face into the independent control image. It's a picture of an old woman, which makes the swap even more challenging, but you don't wanna see easy things here, right? We don't need a prompt, all required information is in the two pictures. Set the sampling method to DPM 2m SDE keras. Resize by should stay 1 as we don't want to resize at this point. We set denoising strength to 1 as the target image shall be heavily modified. Then we have to select the downloaded IP adapter. IP adapter clip SD15 and the model IP adapter plus face and not a different one. In contrast to other cases, starting controls tab is not set to O. We will set it to a value between 0.2 and 0.5. Otherwise, the inserted face might not match the size of the original picture. So you might try different values within this range. I think that's all regarding parameters. And as we only want to swap the face, we copy the image to the InPaint tab. We draw a mask and start with a small brush. Then we'll choose a bigger brush and finish the mask. Let's start the generation. I have to interrupt. I think I made a mistake. The result looks really ugly, cause I've forgotten to increase the number of steps. Something between 50 and 60 is usually a good value. So let's start again. That looks much better. But as you can see, the chin is in the wrong direction. It looks into our direction and not to the side. This can be improved. The trick is to use another control net unit. We enable it and choose the downloaded Open Pose model. You may choose Open Pose Full or Face Only. I prefer Full, it includes everything. And the model, well, it's the Open Pose model. The rest stays as it is. We generate again. Yes, this looks much better. I could have spent more time in painting the hairline, but for the first try I think that's more than acceptable. In fact, upscaling with a higher denoising strength will fix this anyhow. I think a real photo will make things even more interesting for you, right? By the way, if you want to see more videos like this, press the subscribe button. After doing a face swap with two images which have both been created with same model, I think I have to show you a face swap with a real photo. In order to avoid any copyright issues, I choose a photo of myself. Don't be confused about the transparent background. It's definitely not required here. So let's see how this will look like. Well, that's not too bad, especially considering that the control net does not know how I look like from the side. Nevertheless, well, the glasses are missing except for one piece. So let's improve the face swap. We can do this by changing the starting control step somewhere between 00 and 05 or increasing the control weight. As the guy on the target image does not wear glasses at all, I think it's the best idea to simply, well, start with control step 0. Well, that's much better, but still not perfect. The beard is not okay, the hair definitely not, and the same is true for the glasses, but we can change this and improve in the in-paint section. So let's do some very quick corrections. I'm sure next generation won't have any large bugs. Very nice, face, hair and glasses fit to the rest of the picture. And now let's have some fun. We'll choose an alien, you know, someone from an UFO. The skin is blue and there are some technical inserts on the skin. Again, we choose a starting control step of 0.5. I think it's not required to change the control weight. Yeah, looks like we have an alien in a suit at the beach. And we can even see those technical inserts. As a kind of bonus, I'll show you one more thing which can be done with the IP Adapter Plus face. And if you enjoyed the video so far, please leave a like or a comment. The IP adapter for the face swap can even be used in text to image. And in a few seconds you'll see a typical use case. Let's first choose the sampling method as usual. Same for the sampling steps. Height for this checkpoint should be set to 768. Let's just quickly check if a suitable image is generated. Yeah, that suits our needs. You will see in a second why. Again, we'll use the control net and choose a different picture. This time it's a picture of a female robot. I've created this with SDXL. We use the IP adapter plus phase as usual. We increased the control weight to 1.2. In my first test, it was too low. As you can see, several details from the portrait have been included into the generated picture. It includes face, cloth, and skin. And now try yourself.